Take a close look at the image on the screen. Can you tell me what the image is of? This image is of an unborn baby inside a pregnant mother. You must have seen in clinics that doctors use some kind of a special instrument to obtain this image. Now you will be surprised to learn that this device does not contain any camera with it. So how do you think it is possible to obtain this image if there is no camera attached to the device? Well, I'm sure that once I tell you the answer, you're going to be astonished. This particular image is obtained with the help of sound waves. That is right. The sound waves that are used to obtain this image are known as ultrasound waves. So, do you recall what ultrasound waves were? Let us take a very quick recap. So what is ultrasound? Sound waves which has a frequency that is greater than 20,000 hertz is known as ultrasonic sound or ultrasound. So as you might recall, ultrasound is undetectable by human beings as they lie above the human audible range. What does this mean? That sounds that are above 20,000 hertz cannot be heard by human beings. So how do you think this ultrasound is helping us view the image of the unborn baby? Let us find out through an animation. Look closely at this animation. In this animation, it is being shown how ultrasound is helping us develop the image of what is inside the human body. As you can see, this portion in red is depicting a part of the human body. The red part is the blood, and the solid parts that are inside the blood represent organs or tissues. Now, you can see that this device is being held against the skin, very close to the skin. This device sends out ultrasound waves which have a frequency of 1 lakh hertz. These ultrasound waves have a frequency of 1 lakh hertz. Now, this device, when it is held close to the skin, emits waves. The moment this wave hits the interface between blood and the tissue, a part of the wave gets reflected and comes back to the device. Now, you must be wondering, what happens to the other part? Well, the other part of the wave travels on deeper inside the human body, that is through the tissue. Now, when it travels through the tissue, it hits the blood tissue interface once more. When this wave hits the blood tissue interface, again, a part of it gets reflected in this direction and a part of it moves on in the forward direction. In this way, the waves keep getting reflected back from the interface and a part of it keeps going forward into the human body. Now you must be wondering how this is helping us obtain the image. This device, this transducer that is responsible for converting electrical energy into sound energy, has a timer attached with it. What does this timer do? This timer knows when the first wave is being sent into the human body. So when the first wave is sent into the human body, it knows the time at which it is sent. When the first reflection comes back, this timer can calculate the time difference between the sent wave and the reflected wave. Now you know that distance is given by speed into time. So this device knows what is the time taken in between the sent wave and the reflected wave, and it also knows what the speed of ultrasound is in human body. So knowing these two, this device can calculate the distance of the tissue or the depth of the tissue inside the human body. The same is true for all the other reflected waves. This timer knows when the first wave is being sent out, and depending on when the reflected wave is coming in, this timer keeps calculating the time. So when the reflected wave comes in, the timer knows what the time difference is in between the sent wave and reflected wave. In this way, it can form an image. So let us look closely at how the image is being formed. From this device that is held against the skin, many such waves are sent out. All these waves are going to encounter reflections on their way into the skin, and likewise, they are going to come back. So through these multiple reflections, and as these waves travel inside, the timer keeps track of when the reflected waves are arriving. And in this way, it can measure where exactly inside the human body these tissues are lying. Now you must be wondering why we are using such a high frequency. Why 1 lakh hertz? Why are we not using the audible range? Well, there are two reasons. The first reason, think about it. If the doctor holds up an instrument that makes a noise while emitting waves, would you like it? Would you like it if a doctor holds up an instrument that makes an awful amount of noise? No, right? That is the first reason why we do not use the audible range. What is the second reason of not using audible range? As you can see, 1 lakh hertz is a very high frequency. Do you recall what the relation was between the speed of sound in a medium and its frequency? The speed of sound in a medium was given by frequency into the wavelength of the sound. Now, if we have a high frequency, then for a given speed, because the speed of sound, of ultrasound, is not changing in the medium, so for a given frequency, which is very high in this case, we will have a low wavelength. A high frequency and a low wavelength. A high frequency and a low wavelength ensures deeper penetration of the sound waves into the skin. This enhances the device's image forming capability. And this is exactly the reason why we are using ultrasound at such a high frequency to obtain the imaging. Now I have a question for you. Can you find out the wavelength of an ultrasonic wave? You have been given the frequency and the speed of the wave inside the human body. So let us find out how we can solve this sum. The speed of ultrasound in human body, that is inside human tissue, is 1540 meters per second. And the frequency of ultrasound, as we just learned, is 1 lakh hertz. And what is the relation between speed and frequency of sound? The speed of sound is frequency into wavelength. The speed of sound is frequency times wavelength. So what can we write wavelength as? Wavelength, which is given by lambda, can be written as speed divided by frequency. The wavelength of ultrasound is speed of ultrasound divided by the frequency of ultrasound. What is the speed of ultrasound? The speed of ultrasound is 1540. And what is the frequency? The frequency is 1 lakh hertz. So, after we simplify this calculation, we get a result of 0.0154 meters or 1.54 centimeters. 1.54 centimeters is the wavelength of ultrasound inside the human body. Now, We saw all about how human beings use ultrasound to their advantage. Doctors use ultrasound to detect what lies inside the human body. They also use ultrasound to get the image of an unborn baby inside a pregnant mother. Now, do you think any animals use ultrasound? The answer is yes. As you can see on the picture, you see a bat and a dolphin emitting some kind of waves to detect their prey. You will be interested to learn that these waves, the dolphin and the bat are emitting, are ultrasonic waves. So how do they use these ultrasonic waves? A bat is mostly active at night. At night, obviously, there is darkness all around, and bats have very poor eyesight. So how do you think bats are able to see in that darkness? How do you think bats can detect their prey and avoid obstacles? The answer is ultrasound. What bats do, bats emit high-frequency waves or ultrasonic waves in the forward direction. These waves, when they hit their prey or any obstacle in their path, are reflected back to the bat. The moment these waves are reflected back to the bat is able to calculate the time difference between the sent wave and the reflected wave. As the bat knows the time difference, this bat can calculate how far it is from the prey or an obstacle. Because as we learned, distance is given by speed into time. And the bat has a very accurate sense of its speed and the time taken by the sent wave to reach back as reflected wave. In a similar manner, the dolphin underwater also uses ultrasound to detect its prey. The dolphin sends out ultrasonic waves in the forward direction, and the moment these waves hit the prey, they are reflected back to the dolphin. Knowing the time taken by the sent wave to come back as reflected wave, the dolphin can calculate the distance from itself to its prey. Now, you will be interested to learn that human beings have not limited the application of ultrasound to medical sciences only. Take a close look at the animation. In this animation, there is a ship on the surface of the water. Now, this ship, the people on the ship want to find out what is the depth of the ocean bed. Now, there are two ways in which it can be done. The first way is to take a long measuring device and dip it into the sea and find out the depth. But do you think such a long measuring device exists? It doesn't. And even if it did, it would be very inconvenient to dip it into water and measure the depth. So how do you think it is done? What the ship does is, it sends out ultrasonic waves into the sea. These ultrasonic waves travel down into the sea, hit the ocean bed, and are reflected back to the ship. Now the ship knows when it sent out the ultrasonic wave, and it also knows the speed of ultrasound inside the water. So knowing the speed of ultrasound, it calculates the time taken by the reflected wave to reach the ship once the wave had been sent out from the ship. So knowing this time difference and the speed of sound, the ship can calculate the depth of the sea or the distance from the ship to the ocean bed. As you recall, distance is given by speed into time. This method of calculating the depth of the sea with the help of ultrasound is known as sonar. Sonar stands for sound navigation and ranging. So, do you think sonar is used anywhere else apart from measuring the depth of the sea? Now look at this animation. Here you'll find that there is a ship on the surface of the water and there is an enemy submarine inside the water. This is wartime. Now this ship wants to know where the location of the enemy submarine is inside the water. So what this ship does is, It sends out ultrasonic waves or ultrasound in all directions. Now, the moment this ultrasound hits the submarine, it gets reflected and travels back to the ship. This ship can then calculate from what direction the ultrasound was reflected, and it can also calculate the depth of the submarine, because the ship knows the speed of ultrasound in water, and it can calculate the time difference between the sent wave and the reflected wave. So knowing these information, the ship will be able to know where exactly inside the sea the enemy submarine is located. So let's take a quick recap of what we learned. We learned that ultrasound is that sound which lies above 20,000 hertz and is undetectable by human beings. So where is ultrasound used? Ultrasound is used in medical sciences to know what lies inside the human body. Ultrasound is used by doctors to get the image of an unborn baby inside a pregnant mother, as we saw. It can also be used in medical sciences to gather vital information about tissues and organs. We also saw that ultrasound is used by animals like bats and dolphins to detect their prey and avoid obstacles. Ultrasound is also used by human beings for various other applications, like knowing the depth of the sea, detecting whether enemy submarines are present inside the sea or not. This application of ultrasound is known as sonar. Sonar stands for sound navigation and ranging.